everyone. Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. There's a lot of y'all. Jesus. So because this is my music education recital, I have the honor to talk about some stuff with y'all as well as just play for y'all. So that last piece was Entrada by Otto Ketting. Otto Ketting is a Dutch composer of the 20th century. He studied trumpet at the Royal Conservatory of The Hague and studied composition with his father. Entrada was composed in 1958. It begins with a very related melody, like in the two things, but they're purposely different to kind of leave you a little off balance. Ketting's compositional style differs from the functional tonality that many of us are used to hearing in our popular music or some of our more, you know, traditional classical romantic era music. It's difficult playing an unaccompanied piece because I don't have somebody to, you know, lay the groundwork for me. What do I need to do? How do I follow them? It's all on my own. I have to make all of the expression, all the music. And it was a really great challenge for me as somebody who doesn't typically play solo music with an accompanist, let alone without. So it was wonderful. It begins very lamentfully, moving through all these sweeping motifs before getting to a more like declaratory fanfare, which helped me work on some of my orchestral trumpet playing as well with the very intentional playing. And then it concludes as it began, as y'all heard. This next piece I will be playing is Suite in D Major by George Friedrich Handel, German-British composer, heavily associated with the Baroque era trumpet repertoire. The suite that I am playing from includes five pieces from Handel's Water Music Suite that is one of his most popular works. I'll be playing two movements from this suite, the Overture and the Bourée. And when he wrote this, he didn't write it with piccolo trumpet in mind, which is what I'll be performing it on. He wrote it with the natural trumpet in mind. I'm going to set this down for a second. Got it. The natural trumpet has no vowels, as you can see, but it functions the same as any brass instrument does, being able to play a full scale and stuff like that. So I felt like if I'm going to play this piece, I should demonstrate a little bit of it on the instrument that it was originally intended for. So, sure, let's play the top. But just so you have a little idea of what he was working with, it's very difficult playing without the vowels. Everything is coming from my air, from my lips, just having to move through all these partials. It's really impressive getting to hear trumpet players performing like this. So, yeah, but I'm not that good. So I'm going to be playing it on, on the more modern instrument because we have technology. So. Thank you. ahead. This next piece is called Two Portraits, written by Joseph Turin. Joseph Turin studied composition at Eastman School of Music. He worked in many genres, from orchestral works to chamber ensembles, all the way to silent film scoring. He was one of the people that worked on the silent film for Back in the Drum, which is a really cool fact I learned this morning. Two Portraits specifically was written for Philip Smith, who's the former principal trumpet player for the New York Philharmonic, and he's currently the professor of arts and trumpet at the University of Georgia. Turin wrote the piece for the 20th anniversary of the International Trumpet Guild, which our trumpet ensemble here at Loyola actually got accepted to go perform at in May. So that'll be a lot of fun. and it was written, and it's written in a very romantic slash contemporary style. The first movement is entitled Psalm. It's a flugelhorn solo. I will be playing sort of a quiet, soulful chant over this ostinato figure that's in the piano. And there are a few cadenzas in there that, few cadenzas throughout the development that move the piece along before returning to the ostinato figure towards the end of the piece. And the second movement is entitled Incantation, which is a direct, not parallel, it's not like the first one at all. and it contrasts the psalm. It's for B-flat trumpet and flugelhorn. It's much more energetic and lively with a good share of changing meter that was very difficult to work through. There's some melodic lines of the solo part that's above all the rhythmic excitement that's going on in the piano. A lot of contrasting material within the second movement that's always changing, but it's always driving forward towards the end.
Thank you. Thank you.
Since my freshman year here, and it's been one of like the highest points of my music journey here. It's been one of my favorite ensembles every single year, so I just had to program one on here. That first piece we just played was Bang Sang Leader. It's written by an unknown composer, but the arrangement we played was by Robert King. It's very standard repertoire for brass quintet, so it felt very fitting that I would play it here. I've played it pretty much every year in every single ensemble I've been in terms of quintet, so I figured I kind of have to carry it over. The second piece we're going to be playing is Penny Lane by the Beatles. Since I've been doing a lot of piccolo trumpet over the last year, I felt like I had to do something piccolo trumpet and brass quintet as well. And the first thing that comes to mind when most people think piccolo trumpet and they're not super in touch with what piccolo trumpet music is the Penny Lane solo that everybody knows. So I listened to the Canadian brass recording of the Penny Lane arrangement so much. It's a very difficult arrangement, so we won't be playing that arrangement, but I would argue this one is just as difficult. So I hope y'all enjoy.
Thank you.
Carlos on horn, Joshua Korn on trombone, Brady McKnight on bass trombone, and Anna Hills on trumpet.
Thank you.
Thank y'all so much. That was a piece entitled Procrastination Blues. I wrote that one. I was in a lesson one day, and Dr. Bowles told me, you really should play something that, like, you've written before. And I was like, well, I haven't done that. And he's like, well, just start with a blues. And so I sat down, like, 2 days later and just wrote a blues. It worked out. I kind of just took a couple changes I was comfortable with and just started figuring some stuff out on the instrument that I thought sounded good. And so that was kind of the process. It worked out great, I think. I've been playing it for a little while with Cyrus Nabby Force combo here, which he's helped me a lot with helping the arrangements and stuff like that. So it's been awesome. So that's my first ever composition that's been actually performed by anybody in front of people. So thank y'all. This next piece we're going to be playing, well, next piece that I'm going to be playing with everybody else. is entitled I've Never Been in Love Before. It was written by Frank Loesser, which is written as a duet for the musical Guys and Dolls. And like most traditional jazz standards, they take a lot of stuff from musicals and start playing them. So the version that I'm most familiar with is Chet Baker's rendition on his 1959 record of Chet Baker Sings. Wendell Bernius, a local trumpet player, came in to Masterclass two years ago, and when I asked him the question, like, hey, what should I work on for improvisation, he's like, you only need two albums, and it's Chet Baker Sings and Clifford Brown with Strings. And I kind of just stuck with the Chet Baker album, and it's been one of my favorite jazz albums to listen to. And so I wanted to play a ballad off of it, and this is what I went with. I went and arranged a lot of the rhythm section parts to kind of be reminiscent of the actual record that he sings on. But I'll be performing it on flugelhorn because I don't think anybody wants to hear me sing. So, yep.
I don't know, I think he sings.
No, I'm good. Applause doesn't pay my tuition. Right?
Thank you.
So this last piece we'll be playing for y'all, I wanted something that wasn't in the same style as the first two that I played, and I bounced some ideas around with the rest of the group because they're here too. Which let me introduce them. I completely forgot about that. Nathan Schroed on the keys. Lou Herrick on bass. Lou Weber on drums. My left is Anna Hills. Josh Korn again on trombone. And the wonderful Jazz Seals on tenor sax. So I bounced some ideas around with them to find out what other people wanted to play, because this isn't, I know it should be all about me, but I don't want it to be. So, and we landed on St. Thomas, which is a Sonny Rollins tune, fantastic tenor sax player. It's kind of an up-tempo bossa nova type island vibe, which I figured was, yeah, sure, this sounds like fun. Everybody else was really excited for it. I wasn't super familiar with the tune, so it gave me a chance to, you know, work some stuff out. And then I decided to reharmonize the more traditional horn harmonies for the second half of the head, so I don't know. I was having fun reharmonizing stuff, and I was being pushed to do it a lot, so it was really fun to do. So, yeah. Thanks.
Thank you.
right, thank you all so much for coming out and supporting me. I appreciate every single last one of you.
Aww.
That's all, we're not doing it all for. Okay, thank y'all.